Hello and welcome along. Today on Lawfolds, we are going to try and replace our funds a little bit, or replenish our funds a little bit, I should say. We're going to do a couple of missions and see if we can get some cash in before we return to the forage harvester. I actually noticed this on the way back from tipping the last load. So we've got our JCB here, but we are going to clear up this field of sunflowers. The father has let it wither, so we are going to see if he wants it clearing. We need to move our tractor out of the way by the looks of things. We are in the way. So we'll go park this on the grass out of the way over here. And hopefully doing a couple of missions means we can get back to it. Our own tractors are clearing up our own sort of field disasters. Ah, it needs ploughing with a T8. Okay. Now, I want to have a look and see if we can do it with something a little bit interesting. We don't seem to... Oh, we have the 1000 Varia. We will have a go with this again. I had this on the live stream the other day. I quite like this as a tractor. It is way, way, way too shiny, though. But this is the big Vario. It is a mod. Because, obviously, this large Vario is not in the game as it currently stands. Right, and we want to be doing this field this way. I'm not sure how easy it is to reverse up this plow. We'll find out now. The answer to that is not very easy. But, right. GPS on. We want to auto-width it. And looking at it, we want to pull it across slightly as well. There we go. There. There. We'll auto width again just to make sure. Yep. And away we go. Whoa. Quite sure what happened there. Let's try this again. Auto width. That's better. So this is quite a long... This mission is going to take us most of this episode, to be honest. So we are going to be doing... So we're going to be doing some ploughing today with the 1000 Vario. This will be, if it's got that kind of time length on it, then it's going to be quite a good mission as far as getting us some more money in. I managed to miss exactly how much it is. But we'll see how we do. We should be able to do this fairly reasonably. This is a good tractor. And it's a big plow. Right, so we will now turn. And the way we'll do this is we'll do every other row. We'll get the auto turn on as well. But yeah, if we do every other row, then that will ensure that it gets done in the most efficient way we can. And that's really what we're after on this. But the other nice thing about it is that it's a nice long field, so we're not doing lots and lots of turns, which of course adds to the time. You want to sort of do it in the most efficient way you can. Not always the way that I do fields, admittedly. I quite like doing lots of turnings in my harvest, so when I'm doing my own fields, I may actually go across rather than along, which may not strictly be that realistic. But I want to keep it so that I keep things interesting when I'm, you know, when I'm doing the harvest. So, for those who don't know, Sandy Bay is due for release soon. It's a map that was in FS15 and that I never got to play, and I really, really love the look of it. I've been watching Landy's videos on it, and yeah, it looks absolutely fantastic in 17. So I'm going to be moving on to that as to one of my Let's Play series. What will happen with that then is we will no longer be doing our live stream series on Chellington, and instead we will be doing live streams on this map and time that this map has during the week for Let's Plays will be taken by Sandy Bay. So Sandy Bay and Cobra will be our weekday Let's Play series, or weekly Let's Play series. Lawfolds will go full time streaming, so there'll be two streams on the map a week. And Chellington will be finished. So it all depends really as to when this happens, as to when Sandy Bay gets released. But that is the plan as it stands as I record this. These things, of course, very much are subject to change. And it will be a few weeks. Sandy Bay is not likely to be released for a few weeks yet anyway. So we are going to be on our Let's Plays on Lawfolds for a while yet. But just letting you guys know exactly where we stand and what's going on. Yeah, we are on a ploughing mission. And I think that is probably going to be the title of today's episode. Is on a ploughing mission. I do like this tractor, I really do. Because we haven't looked at this in any of our Let's Play videos. We have had a bit of a look at it in the live streams. So this is the big fence. This is the 1050. There's not an official version of it in game. This is a mod. I really like this mod. This mod looks spectacular. Have a look in the cab. The cab is really nicely detailed, really nicely textured. I don't think there's any IC control in it. No, we don't have any IC control in this tractor, which is a pity because I think that'd be quite nice. But it does look absolutely fabulous. And I really like it. There is an alteration that I think needs making to it. If we have a look outside, this is way, way, way too shiny. It's so shiny, you can almost see your face in it. And B, it just takes away from the realism a little bit too much. So I think that's my only criticism of this tractor, is that it could really do with a bit of more of a matte finish. If it had that, it would be almost perfect. very tempted to see if I can do a mod review on it. If I could remember, I will try and discover it, but I'm trying to remember where I found it. Because obviously I want to link to the right mod. And I'm quite pleased to be showing this off in a live stream. Sorry, not a live stream, in a video, in a Let's Play. Because it is a tractor that we haven't got on a map, and is really quite nice. The downside, it's not something I can use on Sandy Bay because it's gonna be too big for that map. It's gonna be a host of smaller tractors we use on that. Because there's not really, it's not really a big tractor map. Now, so this is a 6 meter plow. Wow, so this is as wide as our equipment that's working the other fields. And appears taking just as long to do them as well. This is a fairly large field. Field 26 that our case is working, I think is bigger by the looks of things. And it looks like our 7700 is working towards the end of that field. Not too badly. It looks like it's about to do the headlands. And then that is going to be on sunflower planting duty after that. Try and get the field back to how we wanted it. Missions of this length tend to pay quite well, so it should give us enough of a cash injection to get through the rest of spring. And keep going and keep moving, which is good, which is absolutely fantastic. May even be enough for us to buy some equipment to... Or at very least hire some equipment to handle the silage on handle the silage clamp. We want some fairly heavy bits and pieces for that, I think. What I want to do is change that. How's our... that is going quite well, our cultivator on field 33. 71 minutes remaining to do this, according to that. There's no way that we won't get that done quicker. I'm hoping the auto turn will work a bit better on my way back. Which would be quite useful. Very useful. To do this in one mission is, or to get ourselves back on track in one mission will be fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. And we are actually over halfway through, which is very interesting. This is, we are probably about, well, We are 23 minutes into this, and we are over halfway through. Right, one more row after this, and we will be turning around and coming back. Ah, our 7700 has finished work. That's good. We can't go and deal with it while we're dealing with this, unfortunately. Right, so lift that up. And then we will set the auto turn going and see if it will do it. I'm hoping it will. I'm hoping it will do it better going up a field like this than down the field. Yes, it will. Excellent. It may miss a bit more, but hopefully not enough that it causes a problem. If it does, we'll have to go and get those bits at the end, but we'll see how we do. I think it's going to get the vast majority, and as a result, should complete the mission for us. With time to spare, a lot of time to spare. The angle up here is actually quite sharp. So it is leaving a fair amount, but hopefully not so much that we fail. Well, we won't fail because we'll have enough time to run along this side here and clean this up if we need to. And once we get off this, angle, we should be fine. Which is not a huge amount, so we'll see how we go. It is definitely, it's not doing too bad a job. It's kind of what you'd expect with needing to do headlands, so. From that point of view, I'm quite happy with it. Gonna incab it for a bit. I think. Yeah, it's quite a steep angle, that side of the field there. So, two more rows, and we will be at the end of this angled bit. So at that point we will probably start getting most of the stuff at the ends, which we're missing at the moment. I think the stuff we're missing is not going to amount to so much that we lose. We're at 34 minutes for two-thirds. I think this is likely to take 50 minutes. At this rate, I am... That is my current prediction, really. Yeah, next row, we will be back into straighter ends, and we will catch more of it. Interestingly, I wonder why that's happened. Seems that that's wider. Ah, there we go. I have to make sure that we're still getting everything, but yeah, that was a bit strange. Do not know why it missed that large or that single road there. Maybe we drove it without the without GPS on that row. Possible. Does happen. So we've come to the end of that angle bit. We'll see how this works now, whether this has an easier time of it. It's interesting, to the end you could see it was beginning to miss a bit again. And yeah, I'm going to adjust that ever so slightly, just to make doubly sure that we are getting everything. Because having to come back and pick up single rows would take forever. So we don't want to be doing that. This tractor is getting quite nicely dirty now. It's still very shiny. Yeah, it's still very, very shiny. But with the dirt on it, it has got a little bit more of a matte finish to it. That's the thing, I think it just needs toning down a little bit. Because that shine is still quite bright on it as well. Okay, so we're about three quarters of the way through now. We're about to make another turn. That would mean we're about 40 minutes in as well. So, yeah, that means it's about 50 minutes to do this. Which isn't bad on a 90-minute mission. So as you probably gathered from the length of this episode, I have cut some stuff out. I will see how much I actually had to cut out, but I I don't really like it being a more than about a 40-minute episode. So there will be some bits cut out, mainly bits where I'm not saying anything, I think. But I want to get through the whole thing. I want to do the whole thing as an episode. Now that the shine has got dulled quite a bit, it looks even nicer, I think. And it just, yeah, so it just needs that small texture tweak to make it just a little duller. And then, I think it would be fantastic. How many rows have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 maybe? Oh, is it missing bits again? No, it's not. We're fine. We're all good. We probably won't have to do all 7 of those rows. Depending on how much the headland bits that we haven't done affect that. But we'll see. We'll see what effect that has. This is a mightily powerful tractor. I think our soybean seeding. Yeah, our Case Optimum is going around doing the last bits of the soybean seeding, which is excellent. We do need to get the sunflower seeding going on field 33. But that's all fine anyway. Tomorrow's episode, we'll be doing some bits and pieces with the animals. We need to make sure everybody's watered, I think. But we will check up on the animals first, and we'll see where we are from there. If we need to, then we will do some work with them. If we don't, then we will continue doing the forage work. We could actually check here. So let's just check here quickly. All of our animals need water. So, yeah, there is some work to be done with the animals. So we'll do that next episode. We will get on to trying to get them some food and trying to get them some water. We're certainly able to do it for our... For our sheep are getting up and running. Our pigs, we may have some stuff for, so we will see where we go from there for them. Our cows, of course, the silage and everything is for them anyway, so we have been working for that on them. We could give them some straight grass, actually. That would probably be good for the cows. So we will sort that. We'll do some animal bits next time. We do have that small pile of grass, actually, that we missed the silage clamp with, that we can use and we can put. So we'll go and have a look at that. And see if we can get our cows are most important to make sure they're fed and watered and everything in the summer, because that's when they breed. Our sheep and our pigs breed in the spring, so we are in the middle of that at the moment. So we need to make sure that both our pigs and our sheep are well fed right now. So we will do them first. And we should have, I think we have some stuff in storage that we can feed the pigs. So, yeah, we are going to finish about midway through this row. It is so close to closing it now. and it is about a 50-minute mission. Okay, we're on the very last little bit. It's going to basically close up and finish up any moment. It's just this final little bit. I can see this tiny little slither of black in the pie. And yeah. And it's closed up now, so any moment. Of course, in larger missions like this, it does take slightly longer for that tiny little bit to disappear. And for the mission to be counted as complete, there we go. So, wow. Okay, so we got 37,000 for that, plus 13,000 bonus. So we made 50,000. That will keep us going for a long while. But that's where we're going to finish. We've made a lot of money. We've got back on track. All that remains for me to say is thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest videos from Virtual Farm, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.